Hello everyone, Neil Patel here. Thank you for downloading the latest episode of the Indian Startup Show. I really hope you're having a great 2019. If not, stay tuned, we have Dr. Kataria. He is here to help you. He is the founder of Laughter Yoga University. He started out in 1995 with 5 people and now has over 100, yes, that's right, 100 laughter yoga clubs around the world. So in this crazy episode, he talks about how he all got started, people thinking he was really crazy, and why laughter really is the best medicine, even in the tough times. Also, please stay tuned to the end to hear some audio of a laughter yoga expert with some exercises you can try at home. So please enjoy the show. Thank you. Hello, Dr. Kataria. Thank you for coming on the Indian Startup Show today.
Thank you very much. I'm very honored to be there.
Please tell the listeners what you do.
Actually, I'm laughing for no reason at all.
Okay, yeah.
This is called laughter yoga.
Right.
Now, laughter yoga is a way, it's not a comedy. It's an exercise program where you laugh on purpose, intentionally. It's a voluntary laughter. Mm-hmm. And we practice laughter in a group. Mm-hmm. And when we look at each other, it becomes real and contagious. And this is all about laughing without using jokes, sense of humor, and comedies. Why we do this is because scientifically, our body cannot differentiate between real laughter and fake laughter. You still get the same benefits. Mm-hmm. So this is how laughter yoga has built as a form of a group exercise. So we started with 5 people in 1995, and now we are present in 108 countries.
Wow, amazing stuff.
That's no laughing matter.
No laughing matter indeed. How did you come up with the idea? What was the light bulb moment?
Okay, so I was practicing as a family physician, and also I was editing a health magazine called My Doctors. Mm-hmm. I used to educate people about health, wellness, exercises, diet. So after bringing out this publication, I was so stressed because it's a time-bound thing. So stress was building too much, and I was looking for something to de-stress myself. Mm-hmm. So I tried several things, meditation, yoga. So I used to write article about de-stressing measures. So suddenly in March 1995, I thought of writing an article about laughter is the best medicine. Mm-hmm. So after writing article, finding so many scientific studies about laughter, I said, nobody's laughing. Let me start a laughter club. Mm-hmm. So I just went to a park near my house where I go for a morning walk every day. Mm-hmm. And I spoke to people around, I want to start a laughter club here. People thought, I'm crazy. Say, Doc, are you all right? I say, yes, I'm okay. Let's start. So initially, we were only 5 people. Mm-hmm. Because most people thought this is a crazy idea. How can you laugh in a public park? So we started by telling jokes in the beginning, and people loved it. Our attendance started growing. By 1 week, we were 55 people, but we ran out of good jokes, and most of the jokes were negative jokes, hurting jokes, vulgar jokes, and then came sexy jokes started coming in. So people thought we should stop. This is nonsense. This won't work. Mm-hmm. I said, please don't stop this. Give me one day how to, I'll tell you something, how to laugh without jokes. I'll find out some way. So I was looking for some idea, how can we laugh without jokes? So I read about some research which says that even if you act like a happy person, your body doesn't know whether you're acting or you're really happy. Mm-hmm. You will get the same benefits even if you act out something. Mm-hmm. Any emotion, any behavior, you are acting, your body will respond as if it is a real thing. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So I thought we could make laughter as an exercise. My body doesn't know. My mind knows it that I'm faking, but my body cannot tell the difference.
Sounds fun.
So we started creating laughter exercises in a group. But to my surprise, when we were 50 people laughing, looking at each other, it becomes contagious. It becomes real laughter.
Excellent.
Then we got rid of jokes. We started to make different kinds of laughing exercise, greeting laughter, handshake laughter, milkshake laughter. So I would ask anyone to come up with some some creative way how we can do these laughter exercises. So everybody started contributing to different types of laughing exercises.
Mm-hmm. What's milkshake laughter?
Milkshake is you hold two imaginary glasses of milk and pour one into another, saying, so you drink as if you are, you know, laughing and drinking.
Okay.
So after doing these exercises, I found similarity between laughing as a breathing exercise. When we are laughing, we are exhaling. So this is what people teach in yoga: exhale longer than inhalation, you will get more oxygen. So I thought that we could laugh and breathe together. And then laughing becomes a breathing exercise, which increases the amount of oxygen to our body and brain. And this is how I started naming it as laughter yoga. So this is how it became a discipline. So we laugh, we breathe, we stretch, we added some stretching exercises, as well as we play like kids. Mm-hmm. So grown-up people, when they behave like children, the laughter comes automatically. So this is the technology.
Excellent. And what type of people do you attract?
Most people in India are the morning walkers. They are higher age, 50, 60 plus, in the laughter clubs. But in the Western countries, comparatively younger group, between 35 onwards. Mm-hmm. And we are also started doing laughter yoga in schools and colleges. Mm-hmm. For children. And we ask a lot of corporates, companies are facing a lot of stress, and they find laughter is a very good stress buster. Mm-hmm. So we are doing laughter yoga for companies also. So we have wide range of application, from school children to old age homes, where the seniors sitting on wheelchairs, they can't move, but they can do exercises.
Mm-hmm. And do you have to do like warm-up exercises? And you know, how long does the session last?
Typically, laughter exercises are about 20 to 30 minutes. Mm-hmm. And then we do some stretching, breathing, and some physical exercises, because shoulder, neck movements. So these are the yoga stretches we borrowed from yoga. Mm-hmm. So normally, laughter club members meet for an hour. And in the Western countries, when people meet indoors, we do laughter meditation. We lay down on the floor and close our eyes and just start cracking up one after the other. It becomes hysterical, unstoppable. So this is called laughter meditation.
Okay, cool. What happens if, you know, you're a bit shy and inhibited?
Yeah. So no problem. When you are part of a group, then it doesn't matter whether you laugh little, whether you are shy. So slowly, gradually, when you are participating in a group, you open up your voice and your inhibitions and shyness goes away. Mm-hmm. So next is that, why people are drawn to laughter yoga? Why is it spreading worldwide? The reason it is spreading is because people are getting so many health benefits from it. Mm-hmm. Now, I'm talking about, as a medical doctor, we found that a lot of scientific research studies now done on laughter yoga method, more than 25 studies all over the world. And they found that it reduces stress. And 80% illnesses are because of stress. Mm-hmm. So definitely people suffering from stress-related diseases, they get better. I'm not saying that completely get cured, but at least 50-60% improvement without any medication is remarkable. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And also makes your immune system stronger. If you laugh, you don't fall sick easily. So I'm giving you my own example. When I'm laughing for the last 24 years now, and for the last 24 years, I haven't caught even a single cold. I don't get it. Before, as a medical doctor, I was getting 4 to 5 times in a year, cough, cold, sore throat, fever, flu, whatever. Nothing happens because my immune system has become, because I laugh every day, 30-40 minutes. I get up in the morning, I start laughing. Mm-hmm. And then I do a lot of trainings and do a lot of coaching with laughter, so I keep laughing practically whole day.
Is it true that your mother was embarrassed when she found out what you were doing?
Actually, when I started Laughter Club, it appeared in the newspapers, and my brother came to know about this, and he told my mother. And he called me from my native place. He said, "Madan, please stop doing what you are doing. People are bringing us the newspaper and telling us that you sent your brother to become a doctor in Mumbai, and this is what he's doing now." So he said, "Please stick to medicine. This is not your job." Then I invited them to Mumbai, and when they saw the Laughter Club, everybody was praising them. Everybody is saying that your son has done a great job for the society. So I'm talking about the benefits. First is that it changes your mood within minutes. By laughing, you release endorphins from your brain cells, and it helps you to raise your mood. If your mood is good, you do everything well. Mm-hmm. Also, there are certain other chemicals related to depression, which is dopamine and serotonin. They also go up. Mm-hmm. And depression is number one sickness in the world, mm-hmm. everywhere. So people who go to regularly laughter yoga clubs, they have stopped taking antidepressant pills. Their psychiatrists are surprised that how could they improve so dramatically. So laughter yoga is a very strong antidote for depression, and one of the best way to beat stress. And also, laughter increases the amount of oxygen to body and brain. And you ask any scientist, any researcher, that lack of oxygen is the root cause of most illnesses. Mm-hmm. Like cancer can happen only when there is no oxygen in the cells. So why there is a lack of oxygen? Because people don't breathe correctly. Because of stress, our breathing is very small. Mm-hmm. So basically, we are training people in laughter yoga to breathe deeply, to laugh from the belly, so that they oxygenate each and every cell of your body.
Sure. Is it free then, the yoga clubs? Or is it like a business model behind this?
Business model is not really very strong. It's a social model. Mostly laughter clubs are free. But when I went to West in Germany, in Europe and America, they insisted that I must give them a professional training. Apart from social laughter club, they would like to do laughter yoga with companies, organizations, yoga studios. They want to charge it. So I developed a professional model where people can learn and get certified and do laughter yoga for free. Mm-hmm. But my promise to all the students is that, okay, you do make money whatever you want, but please open one free social laughter club. And this is how laughter clubs are free all over the world. Mm-hmm. But any teaching, coaching, training based on laughter yoga method is chargeable. Mm-hmm. So there is a small professional. It's not very strong. You can't really give up your job and mm-hmm. and start laughing for money.
Yeah, because you do the training. I'm looking at the schedule. It's quite hardcore. It's like 5 days.
Yeah,
starting at 7 a.m. and finishing at like 8 a.m., 8 p.m., sorry. It's quite, hardcore.
Because in 5 days, I have to teach them in every area of application, how to do laughter yoga with seniors, how to do laughter yoga with business people, how to do laughter yoga with the children, school children, mm-hmm. then how to go into the depth of, then give them practice to do laughter yoga sessions, mm-hmm. meditations. There is some spiritual element. So mm-hmm. 5 days is actually too small a period. It should take more than 15, 20 days, but right. people can't afford it.
Yeah.
Spending so much of time.
Yeah, because on day two, between 8 and 9 p.m., you've got the gibberish workshop.
Yeah. What is that? Gibberish is very funny. It's a value addition to our laughter exercises. Gibberish is a language which has no meaning.
Okay.
So you start just to say whatever comes to your mind. Say that I got the Allah, 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 Allah. So when you talk gibberish, you laugh because your brain doesn't understand. It doesn't make any sense. So it's a kind of a tool, one of the exercises we use.
And on day four, between 8:30 and 10:30 p.m., you've got talent stroke fun night.
Yeah, fun night. So this actually opens up people to express themselves and do some dance, some singing, some playing. So people open up. This is not very highly specialized competition. This is just committing everybody to sing, dance, play and laugh. So this is what we are, this is part of our curriculum, mm-hmm. that everybody who is a laughter yogi should know how to sing, how to dance, how to play, how to have fun. We play a lot of fun games. And this eventually, all this activity help you to add more laughter in your life.
Mm-hmm. So you're coming up to your 25th anniversary next year. What's been the highlight?
Okay, 25th anniversary will be in Bangalore, which is our headquarters of Laughter Yoga Movement. And we are having a global Laughter Yoga conference here. People from all over the world. I've got thousands of students all worldwide. They will come to Bangalore to share their experiences. We will cherish all the movement, what we have done to the world, how Laughter Yoga is making a difference to the lives of people. And we will also have some special trainings, workshops, pre and post conference. So it will be 1 week of celebration. And without any marketing, without any, because I don't have a business brain. Without any business aspect, I could reach 108 countries. You know, that's no laughing matter. So that's why I feel that there is a divine force behind this movement, because people are getting benefits from it. And I don't care about money. I'm very rich already. I'm rich in terms of how much people tell me they have changed. So for my own living, a few trainings and corporate programs are enough. I'm not crazy about making money, but I'm a social crusader. And this is what I teach people. People say that, can we live by laughter? Can I make some money from laughter? I say, look, I haven't made in 25 years. So if you can make it, please also teach me.
Wow. It's been an incredible journey. Looking back, has anything surprised you?
Yeah, actually, I never thought it will be such a big movement, and not so so big as I saw it developing. And there are more than 25 scientific studies done in different countries to validate the benefits of laughter yoga. And one of the greatest countries who are following laughter yoga after India is America, Germany, and Japan. Japanese people are crazy about laughter yoga, and they are very serious. But if you go and see them laughing now, you won't believe. Are the same Japanese people. In my trainings, every training, 10-15 people come from Japan.
Seems very popular in Japan. Okay. I mean, do you think the reason why people are miserable and stressed out is because of the internet? You know, social media, etc., etc.?
Yeah, I think laughter yoga is a great delivery system, and people are too much into the mind, too much into thinking. But this is not a thinking practice. This is just a doing it from the body. Your body has more intelligence than your mind. Mm-hmm. So I tell people that easiest way to be happy is to make your body happy, to act like a happy person. So you still get the same physiological and biochemical changes in the body. And once you are happy inside, your perception of the outer world changes. You can laugh when times are good. Laughter gives you the power to keep your spirits positive, keep your mind positive during challenging times, difficult times. So this is a real power of laughter yoga.
Okay. Last question then. For people who want more information on what you do and laughter yoga, what must they do?
One thing I want to, that I got, you know, loads of inquiries about laughter yoga. They say, we don't have a laughter club, how do we laugh? So I want to tell you that on Skype there is a laughter club every hour. Sometime, you know, there are two three laughter clubs going parallel in different countries, different time zones. So please go to my website, www.laughteryoga.org. So if you put laughter yoga on Google search, we are number one. And on the homepage, there is a Skype Laughter Club. So please just try laughing for no reason. Just a group of people from different countries log on to the Skype and they will. So you start laughing and listening to other people laughing. Laughter comes automatically. You don't have to learn to laugh. It's there within us. So please, until the time you can find a laughter club in your area, spreading, but please laugh with us on Skype. Skype groups are spreading all over the world. Mm.
Dr. Kataria, thank you for coming on the show today.
I'm very happy. So I just want to give you one tip to your viewers,
yep,
that how can they just laugh for a few minutes every day? Just try for 1 minute laughter, gentle laughter. Don't have to laugh very loud. Just keep on doing. So in the beginning, it might sound a bit embarrassing, a bit awkward,
yeah,
but soon you will get used to it. Then you can laugh on and on and on. So keep laughing. Last message is that life is serious. A lot of seriousness in this world. It's time to come take laughter seriously now.
Dr. Kataria, I'm off to release some endorphins. So thank you very much. And I wish you all the best.
I love dolphins. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Perfect.
Okay.
The more
okay.
laughing, the better. That's the whole point. Okay. So palm to palm. We wake up the acupressure pants. And then we say ho, ho, ha, ha, ha.
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 And before we do the exercise, I just want to show you where we want our laughter to come from.
Okay.
So if we touch our throats and go hee, 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 hee. This is our throat social laughter, yeah?
Yeah.
Touch our heart, say ha, 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 ha. Then our bellies. Yes, that's exactly it. That proper. That is it. So we'll begin with our exercises.
Okay.
Yeah.
So the whole point is a childlike attitude. Yeah. Eye contact is so important in laughter yoga.
Okay.
So just begin by shaking hands instead of a hello. We laugh. So. Weird and wonderful, right?
It's really weird.
Yeah.
But I quite like it.
Good, I'm glad.
I don't know whether I'm laughing with it or at it, though. That's
either's fine.
Does it matter?
No.
Yeah.
Okay.
So we'll do another exercise, again, laughing for no reason. So we're on the phone to our friend Andy or whoever, and we just laugh.
Andy, hey, it's Andy on the phone.
And he's telling the funniest story. And then
I do feel a bit weirdly, I feel a little bit dizzy.
Yes, that's
why is that?
So it's because laughter yoga, it's an aerobic exercise. So laughter is exercise, because we're getting more oxygen into our bodies, because we're stimulating the blood flow. So think of how much more oxygen you're getting into your body right now. That's so common. Everyone gets
really?
A bit. You have the oxygen high.
Can you feel it? I do feel a bit dizzy. Like, not so much.
I mean, you've been really laughing.
What's the difference between, I mean, we laugh all the time on here, sometimes inappropriately and sometimes very unprofessionally. But when we do laugh, you don't feel dizzy after that.
No.
So this is because we're doing that belly laughter, the proper diaphragmatic belly laughter.
Forcing it almost.
So in laughter yoga, we have to kind of force it a little. Mm. But trust me, after classes, usually 45 minutes after that, after 10 minutes in.
Just be exhausted after 45 minutes.
How often should you be doing this?
Thanks for Dr. Kataria for coming on the show today, and check out the show notes for more information on how to join a laughter club. If you enjoyed it, please leave a rating, a review in iTunes. Thank you for listening, and if you want to come on the show, please email me, hello@neilpatel.co, and let's connect on facebook.com/IndianStartupShow and on Twitter @IndianStartupSH. Thank you and goodbye.